Welcome to this session of video tutorial. In this tutorial, we will be dealing with how to set up a model for modal linear time history analysis using eigen or Ricks vector to perform linear time history analysis. Linear time history analysis is more efficient than using direct integration from the point of view of computation. Let us assume a period of 0.2 seconds for the first fundamental node. Our structure is an industrial frame structure in which all the columns are HEA 200 and the beams are IPE 160. We will be performing a time history analysis on this structure. So let us start. First we will go to the define the MAR source and make it sure that it is element additional mass. So we shall define the mass source and make sure that it is element self mass and additional mass. Now we will define the load. Function time history. Various options are available, but we will be choosing sine. Add new function. In this, we shall be choosing a period of 1. Number of steps per cycle will be 20 and number of cycles will be 5, and we will consider amplitude of 2. For this, these values are time against value, time against acceleration, the values are shown here. So now we will be defining the load cases. We will be choosing Ricks vector, and for this we will be taking acceleration in the UX direction, and the target participation ratio will be 99%. We will add this. In this, since we are using the acceleration in only X direction, there will be only two modes. Maximum number of modes will be 2. So for better results, you can still consider more nodes. Now we will consider a time history load case. Go to load case, add new load case, and this we will name as time history. Here we will apply time history. We will use linear and modal and transient for this, and load will be applied in shape of acceleration, and we shall apply a scale factor of 386.24 to convert each G units into, we shall apply a scale factor of 386.24 to convert G units into inch units. And for this, to get better results, since we have considered a time step of 0.2, when we divide 0.2 by 10, it will come 0.02. And here we will consider 500 steps to get a better result. Now we will run the analysis and view the results. We will set the dead load case to do not run, as it is not needed. We are only interested in the model and the time history analysis now. Analysis is in progress. And here is the deform shape after the analysis. Now we are ready to view the results. We'll go to the display tab. Show forces and stresses. We can see the we will view the result for 1.4 and moment M and moment 3.3. Here we can see the moments moment 3.3. Again we will go to the display tab. We will go to the joints, we can see the results if we go to the joint display. We can see the annual apps also. There are two options, field diagram and show values. This time we will see show values. We can see the envelope here. Now we will select one joint and view the response spectrum curve for this particular joint. Go to select, deselect all. Go to display. Show response spectrum curve axis. We will select period and PSA, pseudo spectral. This is the curve. We will see that the curve is located near the after the first step. So this is one option. If you want to remove the grid, then you can remove the grid from here. And simple curve will only curve will be shown. Here we can note the specs of this. It is for the joint 30 and direction is X, factor is 1 and widening is 0%, damping 1 is 0, damping 2 is 0.02, damping 3 is 0.03, damping 4 is 0.05 and damping 5 is 0.07. and damping 6 is 0.1. So this is about response spectrum. Now we will see the same for the time history analysis. Let us name it as TH30. This is the curve. So we are seeing after the fifth step, the curve is rapidly changing. Here we can see displacement in UX direction. Minimum is this much, and at 2.6 into 10 to the power of minus 1. And maximum is 1.442 and at 3.76. So now I will show you one very exciting feature of time history display. We will change this to 3D view and if you want different time steps, you can go and see from here. You can create a video for this time history analysis. We will save it as video ph. And we will keep the length of the video to say 25 seconds and show graph. You can see how the time history is moving. Now you can save this file. If you do not compress it, the file size will be very heavy. So to save it in a small size, you should always use Microsoft Video One. If you want a tabular display, then press Ctrl and D. Then let us display joint displacements. And in the structure model participation ratios. Shall use only time history for this. So the two values are shown, minimum and maximum values are shown for the joint displacement, and for the model participation ratios we see it is 100, and in the UI direction it is 83%, and in the user direction it is 0. So this concludes this tutorial on time history analysis.